Welcome back, everyone. Sean Stevens here again with Metroplex Mortgage Services and our Loan Pro video quick tip. As the saying goes, knowledge is power. And in today's video, I will identify the key points that you need to know in order to help maximize your qualifying ability. And if you've not yet done so, don't forget to download our newest educational flyer with the link below. This free guide is designed to help walk you through the mortgage qualifying process step by step and is ideal for both home buyers and realtors alike.
So, how do you qualify for a USDA loan with little or no credit history? In a situation where there's been little credit established or no credit history reporting at all, can it still be possible to qualify for a USDA loan? In today's video tip, I will discuss what can be possible for these situations and further explain how it can be possible to qualify for a USDA loan with either limited or no credit history reporting.
USDA credit score guidelines state that a credit score is a statistical number that evaluates an applicant's creditworthiness based on their credit history. The credit score considers payment history, amounts owed, percentage of credit used, length of credit history, types of credit, and newly acquired credit. USDA does not have a minimum published credit score, but instead utilizes the Guaranteed Underwriting System, also known as GUS, to determine the acceptable credit score for underwriting recommendations of an accept, refer, and refer with caution. For loans that receive an accept response, no credit score validation is needed. What that means is that your credit profile could only have one credit score reporting, and provided you receive a GUS accept, then no further validation is required. However, if you receive a GUS response of refer, refer with caution, or for those manually underwritten loan files, USDA guidelines state that the applicant must have two trade lines on the credit report that have been, were, or are open for 12 months based on the date the account was opened as stated on the credit report. A validated credit score does not indicate the applicant has an acceptable credit history. A validated score confirms that one applicant has an eligible minimum credit history. Additionally, accounts such as secured and unsecured loans, revolving accounts, credit cards, collections, and even charged-off accounts may be used to validate the credit score. Remember, if your credit report does not support the minimum accounts required by USDA, that is when you can utilize non-traditional credit.
What does non-traditional credit really mean? A traditional credit reference example may be an auto loan, credit card, or other type of account that is reporting to the credit bureaus. But when a potential home buyer does not have this traditional type of established credit reporting, we still have options that are able to utilize non-traditional credit accounts, also known as alternative credit, to help establish their ability to qualify and repay the loan, with examples being electric bill, water, phone, or rental payments verified through an eligible source. Here's an example of the format we would receive after the account payment history has been verified by our third-party credit vendor. In summary, remember that it can be possible to qualify for a USDA loan with little or no credit history, but minimum credit conditions will apply, and the use of non-traditional credit may not be a substitute for negative credit.
Now we realize USDA qualifying guidelines can be complicated, but that is where we step in to help. My team is built to help walk homebuyers through the USDA process step by step. Just simply call or email to discuss your scenario, schedule a convenient callback time, or complete our online 123 pre-qualifier to get started today. I want everyone to make it a great day and look forward to seeing you right here for the next Tip of the Week.